Several of you, I have only 5 fingers on my free hand. Then I will do it in 5 steps. First, the issue, then the 4 critical consequences for the regulatory frame, because I'm director of a regulatory school. First, the issue. If we are embarked for massive investment, it is to do something. We want to interconnect the internal market. We want to integrate massive renewable. And we want to deploy a big technology change, smart grids, smart metering, smart many things. Is this massive wave of investment going to ask for massive changes in the regulatory frame? Yes or no? Let's start by no. Of course, the market will change dramatically, but the market is a market. Regulated assets, regulated companies, regulated this and that, they do only what they are asked to. They obey. A bit too optimistic. So, big changes. Why? But the existing regulatory frame has never been conceived for massive investment. It has been conceived for the opposite, to reduce costs, so to reduce investment and operating expenses. Then the existing frame is the one of Ryanair, if you prefer, in a continental way, low cost. Second, it is national, it's not international. So how a low-cost national regulation will deliver an international innovation or massive wave of investment? To be discussed with 4 fingers. First one, the first critical dimension for the regulatory frame is coordination. Why? But obvious. Transmission investment is either a complement or substitute to generation. If you generate with no transmission, you cannot use it. So transmission is a complement. But transmission is also substitute to generation. Instead of investing in generation, I can build a line to make the energy coming to me. So if we have a massive wave of investment, we will have massive complement of generation and massive substitute to generation. Wow, a big change. Then what is the value of transmission for a society? But the value of transmission of a society is the services transmission can deliver with generation. So the social value of transmission investment is not coming alone from transmission investment. It is coming from generation dispatch, from generation transformations. Then, if we go for massive transmission investment, we should look at massive changes on the generation side, and we have to combine the two to know what the society will get. And now we have this with cross-border. So we may have massive investment here, massive changes there, and massive benefits somewhere else. That's a big challenge. That's a coordination challenge. I know that young people like Leo think that they have a methodology, CBA, cost-benefit analysis, but you have to check because with young people, you never know what they really want to say, what they mean. Second dimension critical for regulation, it is the economic efficiency of the existing frame. The existing frame is good, but it has been conceived to deliver low cost. It has been to deliver low costs with a defined set of services. Assuming that your TSO is delivering this, that, and this, let's go for low cost. But the set of services does not have to change. Because, of course, if the TSO is cheaper with different services, it's not cheaper, in fact. It may be even more expensive. So how to go for a new set of services and how a new set of services can be regulated? Of course, we have some ideas. We may think that the new set of services will be measured by a new set of indicators. We call it KPI, key performance indicators. For example, hosting renewable will become a service and will be paid itself, the fact of hosting renewable. So it's something new, something different. And we may think of other performance indicators. But then, to pay the service, we will pay the service bit by bit, piece by piece. So we will buy a service to the TSO. But that's the opposite of what we do today. Today, we put a cap, and we put the cap the lower possible. Tomorrow, we have to buy services. How to do the shift? We know also that investment is mainly capital, raising money and putting this money into a given technology. How to make it cheap? If we lower the risk, we will lower the money to give the investors. So a key factor is not to reduce operating expenses, OPEX, what we are doing since 10 years or 20 years. The key factor is to lower the risk for investors. How to lower the risk? Do we need to give them guaranteed revenue? Guaranteed revenue for a very long period, 15 years. So instead of regulating companies every 4 years, we're going to regulate only once every 15 years. And will investors believe that we will do it? And will they put their money into this rosy picture or this trap, depending which way it goes? Look at Bulgaria, Spain, and the like. Another aspect, always the same, economic efficiency. How to invest less to reach the same target? We will reach the target, the new target, but with less expenses. If we want to do this, we have to incentivize users. And users of the grids are mainly big consumers and generators. To incentivize the users, we should quit shallow cost. If we ask the users to individually pay only a few fees, and all the costs are socialized among all the users, no user really takes care of the cost of itself, or himself or herself. I'm French, you know. So English is something I use, a tool, but not a language that I adore personally. So shallow cost is an issue. But the second issue, so should each user pay a big amount of our costs or only a small amount? And do we have to socialize a lot or only a little bit? And second, when we allocate the cost between generation and consumers, G and L, L for load, do we have to ask generators to pay fully, to pay a lot, or like in France, to pay near to nothing, or like in Germany, not to pay? Even the new super grid in Germany is for free for the industry. That's it. So how to do massive investments while not giving new incentives to users? Question mark. Third dimension, massive financing. Is it feasible? We want massive investment. Okay, good. But we need then massive financing. How will we get? Today, the grid tariffs we have, are conceived to deliver low costs and mainly low prices, low tariffs. And a big part of the legitimacy of regulators is to keep the tariffs low, as low as possible. Even in my country, I can tell that the regulator is very keen to lower the tariff, to show that the regulator does something. But how to combine this with massive investment? Are you going to attract investors if you have very low tariff? Let's look at publicly owned company. Can publicly owned company borrow more? So we will finance it through debt. May we think that we can increase the cash flow of the publicly owned companies by changing the rules for amortization? But not the benefits, so they will not benefit more, but they will get more money? Or do we think that the public owner of the publicly owned companies will recapitalize the companies, will put more capital in it, and then the company can invest more? You will tell me at the coffee break. I think that any of these remedies are difficult, And I guess that in most of our countries, we will end with increased tariffs, even if the company is publicly owned. Let's go for private company. May private company attract massive funding? What rate of return? So the existing rate of return, which is pretty low in many countries, or a higher one? What is then the good ratio between the debt of the company and the equity? We know that the more equity has debt today, the easier it is to give big benefits to the owner of the equity. But is it the case? Do we have private companies having such a favorable ratio that they can easily increase the benefits to their owner? Or, again, are we going to increase the rate of return and then immediately to increase the tariffs? Another way being explored is to isolate the new investments from the old ones. The old ones will stay very poor, let's say, or lean, or athletic, but the new ones will be fat or bigger to attract. We may do this, and there is a new word being used in this area, being massive project financing, which is possible. Then it says, first, the new business will not be the business of TSOs, but of new actors, new investors. TSOs will manage the old grid and operate the new one, but won't own the new one. But these new investors, again, to deliver quite cheap grids, will ask to reduce the risks, then to guarantee their revenue, then to have longer contracts. How will we cope with this? But good aspect, project financing can immediately be international. So we do not need that the five TSOs are ending the decade of discussion among them to take a decision. We can take the decision at the front, but we kill the existing TSOs to create a new kind of investor. We are going to the end. The end is not the lightest part of the discussion. It is the reduced. The fourth critical dimension for regulation, it is a redistributive aspect of massive investment. As soon as we do massive investment, we have seen in the first aspect that we massively change the generation costs and then the generation benefits and then the market price. So we will have markets in which price are going to be down, other markets price are going to be up, generators will lose there but win there, and consumers the opposite. How will we allocate the rewards to the winner and the losses to the loser? Who will do? How to do it not only in one country, but the two, the three, or the four countries being involved? Good luck. But someone will have to do, or someone will have to bear the blame. I know that at European level, and I'm strongly European, we use the notion of European social welfare, and we are right. But I know also that at the member state level, many players, if not all of them, are using only member state social welfare. How will we combine these two dimensions? I will conclude. We have seen we have problems with redistributive aspect of massive investment. We have problem with the financing of massive investment. We have problem with the economic efficiency of massive investment and with the coordination of massive investment. What else? I'm afraid that my friend's regulator will get more nightmares than dreams in the coming period. Thank you.